intention, which is, what if we have lots of time? Okay. What if we have not only one book, for example, but 14 billion books that were written every year, and you have 14 billion years? Maybe you'll have a rational book. But there's a problem with that understanding.
You are looking at a book as a complete product. We did not start as a complete product. Do you agree with that?
Agreed.
So in time, we became something else.
Agreed.
Exactly.
Yeah, but there's a difference. Listen
okay,
to this.
What's the difference?
The difference is
the fundamental building blocks of the incomplete product does not have potential for rationality.
How do you know?
That's the question. Okay, good.
Your point, wait a minute. What you're trying to do, I can see the look in your eyes glossed over look. You're just trying to bring focus and say,
I love you, bro.
Wait a minute, hold on a minute. No gating, man, we don't deal with that. What I'm trying to say to you is this, right? When it comes to, let me say something to you, right? I'm going to say to you, when it comes to how you're behaving, you just want to say that your view is going to be right. And you're digging for something.
No, I'm not saying that.
You're digging for something.
Don't assume about me. I'm having a nice conversation with Maxwell.
I can see already.
No, you can help.
You've got a focus.
You can see the unseen?
I could just
proof of God, he could see the future, guys. I'm not doing that, guys.
You got a focus.
You
just want to try. You're trying to dig up so you can try
hand on heart.
Undermine
if
everything.
If he proves me wrong, I'll suspend this argument. I'll never use it again. Hand on heart. Look at me.
If he shows this argument is wrong, I am telling you, I'll dismiss it. I'll take it out of my book as well.
Okay. So, Maxwell, so you were saying, which is, this is means that we're having a very rational discussion. You start with basic principles.
Okay.
And I'm not raising my voice out of anger, just
passion, noise, and I just love it, yeah?
Okay.
So, basically, what you're saying, Maxwell, right, is you're saying, how do you know physical processes are not rational?
Okay.
Now, that's the interesting thing. Doesn't naturalism dictate that there is no intention or purpose behind physical things?
Okay.
Because when you say rationality, you're saying an intended or purpose.
The point I was trying to make is, how do you know what the end product of the physical process will be? In this case,
you know why?
Because
we both agreed. Me and you've agreed that if something doesn't have the potential for rationality,
how do you know it doesn't
continue?
Have the potential
okay,
for rationality?
But the minute you argue that physical processes have potential for rationality and they contain rationality, worse for atheism. Because atheism dictates that there is its mind indifference.
I never said.
You know your book? He's saying exactly the same thing, bro.
Pitless
indifference.
Here's the one I'm trying to make. You started this argument, and I'll mention it again. You started it with the point that because we are created by God.
No, I didn't say that.
No, he
forget him.
I couldn't forget him.
The reason I want to speak to you, Maxwell, is because I like you.
I like you too.
I want to start with principles that have no religious connotations.
Well, you see,
I didn't want you to filter things. I don't want you to. I want us to come with a pure understanding of reality, right? So we both agreed with the basic point, which was if something doesn't contain rationality or even have the potential for it, rationality can't arise from
Here's the point.
You agreed with that point, right?
No, I don't agree.
Now you don't agree.
No. How you do you know before? It doesn't contain rationality?
Okay, good.
How do you know it doesn't have...
Can I address this? From what I understand, an electron doesn't have a mind. Do you believe an electron has a mind?
Yes. Okay.
Can an electron see?
It doesn't have a mind,
Does it see?
It doesn't see.
Good. Okay. So what we discussed, we have to define what rationality is.
Okay.
Part of rationality, for example, in deductive logic, you have something that necessitates a truth, meaning the conclusion necessarily follows from its previous premises, right? Yes?
Okay.
So it sees, it has an insight, if it's true, of course, you have an insight into a conclusion, an insight. So you see into a conclusion. From all I know, electrons don't have eyes, they don't have minds. Is that correct?
Yes.
Well, there you go. That's why physical processes...
That doesn't make sense.
Why?
Because we are talking about the end product of that electron.
Yes.
Yeah. You understand?
But you've already agreed...
No, you've already agreed...
That if the beginning point has no potentiality of rationality...
I never agreed to that.
You did.
I never did.
Okay.
You said to me. Yes.
You remember when we shook hands and at least we agreed on some fundamentals?
No, that was not what we agreed on.
Okay, let me repeat, just to repeat.
Okay, go ahead.
Human beings, we forget. If something doesn't have the potential...
Okay.
...for rationality...
Okay.
...and doesn't contain rationality...
Okay.
...would you agree that a rationality can't arise?
Here is the problem.
As a principle.
No, here's the problem.
It doesn't agree.
How do you know it doesn't have the potential for
Forget
rationality?
That.
I'm talking about a principle. Forget applying the principle.
Okay.
Forget the application. Let's start with principle.
How can we forget the application?
No, because science is based on theory, then practice, right?
Okay.
A testable idea, then you do the experiment. Okay. So let's start with a testable idea, right?
Okay.
Let's start with some fundamentals. For example, before you have science, you need to believe in causal connections, right?
All right.
It's part of the philosophy of science.
Okay.
You need to believe in the real world, right?
Okay.
You can't really prove the real world is real, but you have to believe in it.
Okay.
So the point is this. Let me tell you. As a rational principle, would you agree that if something does not contain rationality, or even have the potential, rationality cannot arise? Do you agree with that?
No, I'm not
agree.
Going to agree, because how do you know it doesn't contain rationality?
What is it? What is it?
That's the point.
No, because
listen to me.
No,
we're
no,
talking
no.
about a rational principle here. Forget applying it to an electron or to someone's godfather.
Let's just talk about the basic thing, right? I would not agree with you, because in realm of what we're talking about, you understand? He was trying to convince me that.
Maxwell, I told you 100 times, speak to me, not to him. Right?
I know,
you're speaking
but,
to me now.
But the argument,
and I really want to be proven wrong. That's why I'm talking to you. Because I want to develop my argument.
If you want to
so I want to be proven wrong.
If,
I am.
If you,
and I'm asking you a question, because I don't want to come across like you believe in magic. Because at the moment, the conclusion is, if rationality can come from something that doesn't contain rationality or even have the potential for it,
okay,
what difference is there from hocus pocus?
Okay.
That's my point. I don't
is
think,
it possible
and I don't think you're a magician.
What I'm saying is, okay, a scientist conducts an experiment.
Yeah, absolutely.
Takes what? Maybe a couple of months, years?
Yeah, sure.
How long have the universe been in existence?
Oh, 14 billion years almost.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you know what could have happened in that time?
That's what I'm saying to you, my brother. All I'm saying is time is irrelevant. Because I said, if in the beginning.
When is the beginning?
But that what difference is there then? I have a hat.
No.
And
is,
I say after 10 minutes or 10 years, I'm going to bring out from this magic hat the Empire State Building.
Yes, it is.
The point is, time is irrelevant.
You're going to agree to this argument.
No, I want us to be... Maxwell,
You're not going to win. I'm not going to win.
No, it's not about winning.
No, I'm telling you it's about winning.
I just sincerely want you to be more rational than me.
I want you to adopt more rational arguments than me.
And I'm sincerely saying... Yeah, but
if I wasn't a very rational person, I would believe there's a God who is in charge of the universe.
Maxwell.
I would believe
okay,
a man
that's
could,
fine. Maxwell.
That's an irrational
person. I like your politeness.
Yeah.
All I'm saying is, I want to go back to the basic principle, because you did agree, then you just changed again. I didn't like that.
No.
We haven't applied it to electron yet. Let's just be general principles. If something doesn't have the potential,
okay,
and doesn't contain it,
okay,
can that thing that we're talking about,
what?
For example, rationality.
If something, anything,
an electron, a bus, a car, a brain, anything.
Okay. What?
A brain doesn't have a capacity for being rational?
No, I'm not saying that. Of course it does.
Okay.
But I'm trying to account for it. But this is the point.
But that's his point.
I want I want him to understand and go back to what he agreed on, which was, if something doesn't contain rationality, right? And doesn't have
the
potential for rationality, can it be rational?
It depends what you're talking about.
Explain what I'm saying. What is the it?
Anything.
You have to be specific.
An electron, a brain, a human being.
Okay, I've read in that respect, but that's
good.
Not...
Excellent.
No, but that's not what we're talking about.
You haven't let me finish my argument. If we don't agree on one point, we want to agree on another point.
The brain is made of electrons.
Absolutely. Accordingly.
And provided you give it enough time, it will get into a structure which actually produces rationality.
Okay, good. This is called emergent materialism, right?
All right.
I did a postgrad in philosophy, so sorry about the big words.
No, that's all right.
Emergent materialism basically means...
Don't apologize for being learning.
No, I'm not learning.
Yeah.
No, you are.
True knowledge is that which makes you realize you don't have any knowledge, right?
All right.
That's why I'm sincerely want to discuss with you. I know I'm a bit passionate, but I'm telling you, I really want to sincerely discuss with you. So, okay, emergent materialism is basically that you get a physical process that can't account for the outcome, right? This is in consciousness studies.
Right.
In the science of consciousness or neuroscience or the philosophy of the mind, you have this idea of the hard problem of consciousness. We have innate subjectivity. They can't account for subjectivity. So what they're saying is emergent materialism is as follows. That you have a non-conscious physical process, but if you have them all together in such a complex way over time, it will bring about subjectivity, consciousness.
Yeah.
That not many people agree with that anymore. Let me tell you what the contentions are. The main contention is what I've just said. that if the building block of all of this complexity and time is fundamentally based on something that does not contain subjectivity and doesn't have the potential for subjectivity, then that approach to explain subjectivity fails. Likewise, if we apply it to rationality.
That's just somebody's opinion.
Of course it is.
Yeah.
But we're rational, we're trying to assess which is most right.
But
I don't want to leave it. You know
what?
I have a hidden agenda. I don't want to leave this table, you thinking that something could arise from something, that something could arise from something that didn't contain it in the first place or didn't have the potential for it. Because that, by all standards, is believing in magic. That's why. Absolutely. I don't want. I'm a humanist
a human
here.
Brain.
I don't want to go away saying this is a magician's table. Absolutely. I'm ignorant on a million things, bro. I'm an ignorant on a trillion, an infinite number of things.
Yeah.
I'm the biggest ignoramus. I know. But what I'm trying to do, Maxo, is.
Nobody knows everything.
Yeah, but there's one thing.
You talk about things in general. You talk about human brain.
Yes.
Does the human brain have the capacity to become rational? The answer is
absolutely.
Yes. Absolutely.
Exactly.
But
exactly.
Under my worldview, that makes sense. Okay, the human brain under my worldview makes sense that it could be rational.
Right.
Because part of rationality is that you have an insight into a conclusion. You see beyond the physical, right? So under naturalism or atheism, everything is just reduced to physical processes or electrons, then that can't be accounted for. That's why you have this big discussion in consciousness studies, in neuroscience, in the philosophy of the mind, that they say, well, how do you explain our ability to reason, even our ability to have a subjective experience of eating a potato that's been cooked on a Sunday, right?
Okay.
That's an inner subjectivity. So your argument is basically time and emergence, which is, it's not irrational. It's a valid point in the academia. Yeah, I'm just saying, it's a valid point in academia. But just because it's in academia doesn't mean it's right. So my problem with this, the main philosophical argument against emergent materialism, the fact that you have lots of complexity, lots of processes and over time and complexity, you have something that doesn't belong to its basic component. The main problem with that is this, it's based on the rational principle that rationality or anything cannot come from something if it didn't contain it in the first place or it didn't have the potential for it. So the argument is here. And again, I use the argument of this table. If, hypothetically speaking, this book is irrational. If I add another book...
No, please, put books
sorry,
down.
Sorry.
Let's talk about the human brain.
Okay,
right?
The human brain is based upon physical processes, right?
Right.
If I take one physical process, and that physical process does not have the potential for rationality, it's not rational. And I add another one, which doesn't have the potential for rationality and is not rational. And I add another one, if I add them all together, then we cannot even claim rationally to say that it would produce rationality. For me to do so would be equivalent of saying, was it abracadabra, right? And then magic.
Okay.
All right. Do you see my point now?
Sorry.
Maxo, I think the penny's dropped.
Sorry.
I can see
no.
I'm
not, one second. You take a piece of metal, that there's no way you can throw it up in the air and it stays there, yeah? You take some plastic, you throw it up in the air, it falls down. But if you put them together and make an aeroplane, it can fly.
Yes.
So you can have an emergent property coming out of this unrelated
thing. This means your mind is working out. I really like this.
Thank you very much.
But there's a problem with your example. Let me humbly say why I think your example is problematic. The metal actually acts with something outside of itself for it to float, which is whatever the laws of physics and the air and whatever, right?
It's just air pressure.
It's not intrinsic
air.
Yeah. It's not intrinsic.
There's less pressure above the wing.
Yes.
And there's
so it's
more
pressure
underneath, so it rises up.
But that pressure is not in the metal. So we're talking about the thing itself. So what you were saying, if you were to apply it to the mind, therefore the mind has something else to be rational. That's not the case here.
No, it's the workings of the mind that produces rationality.
Okay,
it's not the
but then we exactly then we go back to
it's
the same
not the
point.
Electrons themselves. It's just the way the mind operates.
Good. But I would argue, as someone who doesn't agree with emergent materialism, that you can't take a single process and add all those processes together in a complex way in order to have something that doesn't belong to the first process in the first place. Meaning, if it's non-rational and it doesn't contain rationality or the potential for it, then you can't have rationality arising. That's a very basic principle to understand. Your example was different. It wasn't about emergence. It was about adding something new, such as pressure. Adding something new, such as pressure, and however, I don't know how planes work, right? See, I'm ignorant of many things, bro. So, but the point is, you're adding something new. We're not adding anything new here. Now, if you do believe in emergent materialism in that way, then tell me what you're adding new to the brain for it to be rational.
First of all, you're adding a very long process of learning. Yeah,
we don't
necessarily come out as rational beings, even today.
We have the potential.
You have to go to school.
It's a learning process.
You have to go to school and be taught so many different things before you end up as a rational person.
So you're misunderstanding the principle again. We're not saying just because the brain is rational, you're going to be rational. We're saying you have potential for rationality. So obviously, if someone is a child, they're not going to be super rational straight away.
That was the example I gave him earlier.
The reason I'm saying your example is wrong is because the principle is that this brain has potential for rationality.
Okay.
But according to the emergent model, according to the physical process model, there is nothing else. Then you can't account for even the potential of it. That was my point.
No, we've accounted for everything. But you want to dismiss what we've said.
No.
Are you defending his position, or are you defending? Are you how do I say?
I want from this discourse. Yes? I want the most coherent argument to emerge.
Okay.
And what I'm saying so far, with humility, is that adopting emergent materialism here is not going to work for what I've said.
Okay.
Because if you don't have the potential for rationality,
his argument started with the idea.
Forget him. You were talking to me.
No.
Forget him. You were talking to me.
Just a minute.
We're building a basic principles.
Okay.
My brother. You talk to this atheist with snowboarding. With snowboarding. You said to this gentleman, misunderstanding. And you said to him with humility. Let me say something to you.
Yeah, absolutely.
These people are atheists as a reaction to the rationality of the white man. Second, as a reaction to Christianity, because Christians were colonialists and they enslaved the black man. And as a rationality to Islam, because Muslims and Arabs enslaved the black people.
Sure.
I am saying this as a Muslim.
Yes, sure.
They enslaved the black man. This is the rationality. If you would like to talk to them, then talk about this.
Okay.
And if you are an Asian,
I'm not Asian. I'm European. I'm Greek.
If you are Asian, the Asian are even worse. They don't integrate with the black people.
Okay.
At all.
We have racism everywhere. Racism is wrong.
Are you a Muslim?
Racism is haram.
Are you a Muslim?
Alhamdulillah.
Are you a Muslim?
Alhamdulillah. Yes.
Okay. Then you talk with this rationality of the white man. These intellectuals, they don't need the rationality of the white man from you.
They don't need anything from me.
Talk to them are a Muslim.
I was getting there.
And tell them Islam justify slavery.
Yes, agreed.
There's slavery.
Slavery.
There's slavery among the Muslims.
Where?
Again, it's the white man.
The only slavery is between the...
No, there's slavery still now. It's still now.
Let him talk. Carry on.
Yeah.
Let him finish.
No, but it's divergent from the main point if you...
Yeah, but what you had to say was good.
I agree with him. I agree with him.
Not something
else. Maxwell, the main point we're talking about, right, is starting from a basic position, which was,
you are from Asia.
If this physical process, which you said the brain is made up of many physical processes and electrons, they do not contain rationality, right? And they don't have the potential for rationality.
Okay.
How can rationality emerge from this? That's my point.
Okay. Because we're gonna spend all day.
Okay, let me end then. Let me end on this, and then I'll let you have the last say.
Okay.
So this is the conclusion.
Yes.
The conclusion is, as a basic principle, you cannot have rationality emerging from a physical process that doesn't have rationality or the potential for rationality.
Okay.
To claim such a thing is hocus pocus, and you're not a magician, right? And the reason I mention this to you is because our conception of the divine, which is Tawheed, the oneness of God, makes sense of these basic realities. Yeah.
You just said you're a humanist. What religion are you practicing again?
Islam.
You just told me you're a humanist.
No, I didn't mean ideologically.
No.
I care for you.
No. You said you're a humanist.
Yeah, but we have different meanings.
You cannot be a humanist and be a
hold on a second. I'm being human towards you. The Prophet Muhammad, upon whom be peace, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said,
all this while.
You're not sincere when you're saying
that. Can I?
Exactly. All this while.
Of course I was being sincere.
All this while.
You're not listening.
All this while. You you're arguing as a Muslim, not actually as a scientist. You've been arguing as a Muslim.
You're confusing me.
No, because
what
that's
talking about?
All this time you've been telling me to he's gone. You've been telling me to ignore his argument. All this time you've been trying to defend his argument.
No.
You're getting me confused. That's what I've just realized now.
Maxo, that's what I'm saying. All I'm saying to you is Prophet Muhammad. Let me finish. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said in, it's narrated by a tradition in Bukhari, he said that love for annas, love for human beings what you love for yourself, right?
Okay. That's what he said.
Would you consider that the golden rule?
If that's what he said, good for him.
Yeah, that's good.
I don't believe
in
none of
that. That's fine.
Yeah.
You don't like loving for others what you love for yourself?
No, I can do that without
that's fine, agreed. But all I'm saying is, if that's my reference point, then I'm being human to you. I'm humanistic towards you because I'm taught to be that.
Okay.
That's my point. Okay. Don't get confused.
And the point is also, you can be humanistic without an order.
You could display those behaviors, no problem. You could believe in the Cookie Monster and display human behavior. I don't have a problem with that.
So the more you know about Islam, the more humanistic you become.
I believe if you follow Islam, then you reached the summit of character.
Does Maxo al-Baghdadi
does he know something about Islam?
Let me tell you something,
Does he know something about
Islam? I don't know, we'll have to ask Stalin and all those guys. Yeah?
Oh yeah?
But let me say something,
Why does he have a PhD in Islamic studies? And yet he knows nothing about
Islam. The only PhD I know is the private hire drivers. I don't know who
PhD is. Maybe he does Uber in his spare time.
Maybe. Listen to me. Can I finish on this point?
No, because...
We agreed on a basic principle. We agreed on a basic principle, my friend.
You know what?
And that basic principle is rationality cannot emerge from non-rationality.
You know I'll tell you something, and I hope you will end this argument. All the while I've been listening to you,
it doesn't matter what my beliefs are at the moment. It does.
Because if you are arguing,
it's just the thought police.
No.
I mean, honestly, this is an atheist table.
It's not the thought police.
Is this the thought police?
No, it's not.
They don't read their books. They don't read their books.
It is, bro. I was talking about a sincere position.
The books.
He didn't read this book. He didn't read this. I asked him.
Who didn't read this book?
You didn't know.
Just because you are dating doesn't mean you have to read every book. Don't join Daesh. Be an atheist.
If Islam means joining Daesh, it is better to become an atheist.
They don't read it.
Why they don't read it? Because they don't know English.
There's only one version.
I think it's very reasonable to say that you can't have rationality from something that is not rational and doesn't have the potential for rationality. This is why atheism or philosophical naturalism cannot account for that, because as we agreed, it's just physical processes. The only argument you came to me with was emergent materialism. We discussed why that was false. I'll leave it as that. Our worldview, believing in the oneness of God and worshipping Him, makes sense of that, and that was it. And that's it. I've planted the seed. But let it be noted that today, what day is it today?
Shred of evidence for your God.
The day today is the 18th September. It's 5:35 on Sunday, the 18th of December 2016.
Okay.
And for the love of God, you should change. You should change. Not London black atheists, but London black magicians. Because what you've taught us today,
you're saying rationality can come from something that no one believes in the magic man in the sky. He's not a man, bro. Do you believe in magic? That's an irrational position to take. What's a rational position to take? You haven't given a shred of evidence for your God, and you're claiming that He gives us rationality.
Exactly.
That position is itself irrational.
It's irrational.
Why is it irrational?
Exactly. Yeah, because there's no shred of evidence that your God exists.
For God's existence. You understand?
That's the definition of miracles, evidence. Okay. This is not going anywhere, right?
Because Maxo, you've already agreed. You're saying to me that something could arise from nothing.
That's what you're saying to me.
I never agreed to that. And I feel insulted when you say we should change that.
because with due respect, Max, so I'm not offending you. All I'm saying is, you've given me the basis of magic here.
Do you believe in magic?
That's irrelevant. My belief is irrelevant now. My belief is irrelevant now.
Your belief is irrelevant.
You said to me that rationality can come from something that's non-rational and doesn't have the potential for it.
Do you believe in magic?
No, do you believe in magic?
Answer that.
My beliefs are irrelevant.
Did Muhammad fly to heaven on a winged horse?
That's not magic.
I
believe in the metaphysics.
Flying to heaven on a winged horse is not magic.
Of course not magic.
And you believe that?
Do you believe in magic?
And you call yourself a rational person?
Bro, if 200 years ago someone told me that there's going to be an electron, I lived 200 years ago, they would have laughed at you. I would have laughed at you. If 300 years ago you said to me the universe came from a big explosion, for example, a singularity, they would have said that was magic.
Okay.
So let's have some intellectual humility.
What wingspan did a horse have?
Listen to me.
It's a flying horse, man.
I believe that you can't get rationality from a physical process that doesn't contain rationality or have the potential for it.
I
don't want to answer that question. It's irrelevant.
See, so I'm
not
going to answer
your question.
You have.
No.
That question is very relevant.
I asked you a question. Do you believe in magic?
I'm not asking.
You do believe in magic? Alright, that's the end of the conversation then, if you do.
You know why? Because you've proven it today.
Because you said that rationality can come from a non-rational process. You've made a very, very rational argument. But then, when you said to me, we should change the name of from London Black Eddie to London Black Magician.
You've made many jokes today.
No, the reason that is because if you, as a learned man and also a Muslim, if you believe that somebody, you understand, could ascend into heaven on a flying horse, then by all means you believe in magic.
No, that's impossible. What, define magic?
Magic is something which defines logic.
Which defines logic?
Yeah, okay. And for somebody to ascend into the sky on a flying horse.
Yes.
That is
why is that logic incoherent?
My brother. Okay. That's good. Why.
Have you studied metaphysics?
My brother.
No, I haven't.
Okay, good. So let me just ask you a question. Okay. Do you know what something being logically impossible means?
Okay.
Do you know what it means?
It means it couldn't be possible.
Yeah. But what does that mean?
What it means?
So is it possible to have a flying horse?
No. You cannot have a flying horse.
No, it is possible, logically.
No, it's not logically possible.
No, from your limited experiences.
You're missing the point.
I'm trying to teach him a principle here.
All the prophets
who
performed miracles.
Excuse me.
People saw it.
Sir,
but Muhammad said he went to heaven.
Listen to me.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a human being.
One second.
To have a flying horse.
Why?
Period.
Why?
Why? Because show me one.
That's not to do with logic.
Show me one.
No, you're conflating two things here.
Listen, Maxwell, you are conflating logical possibilities with empirical realities.
My brother.
That a horse could
My brother.
Is that a logical
Is it logically possible that you could have a flying horse?
Talk about rationality.
Well, you need to study philosophy.
No, you're wrong. Where is the horse?
That's a different question.
Where's the evidence?
Let me tell you.
No.
Let me finish.
Okay. Just a minute.
It's not logically possible. I'll tell you
what. Okay, is it logically possible someone to know 50 languages?
Wait.
Someone to know 50 languages?
Is it logically possible? No, wait, on my turn. Is it logically possible that someone knows 50 languages?
Don't let him make circles.
Is it logically possible someone to know 50 languages?
The answer to that is, I don't know.
What about 10?
You could know 10 languages.
Do you know someone who knows 10 languages?
I don't know. But
there you go, you just refuted your argument.
No.
It's logically possible, you don't know the reality.
No.
Is it physically possible though?
A horse cannot physically fly.
But it's not a horse like you think of horses. There's a difference.
Is it physically possible?
A horse is a horse.
It's a flying horse, it's different from a horse.
What is a flying
horse? It's called a burak, it's not a horse.
My friend, a horse has got four limbs. Yeah?
We're not talking about a horse the way you know a horse is.
What kind of horse?
We're talking about something called Barak. Barak is different.
What is a Barak?
The point is, we have.
Hey, take it easy.
What are you doing, Adam? Look, where's your adab, ya chef? Look, why are you hitting people? Why are you hitting people, ya chef? Don't hit, haram, haram.
Don't talk about haram.
You can't hit brothers.
Because we don't.
You can't hit brothers.
We don't want to be Daesh.
You're haram.
And we don't take
money. Well, why do you act like Daesh? Don't act like Daesh. Don't act like Daesh.
Look, brother, let me say something.
Haram.
There is no rationality in Islam.
There's a difference between logical possibilities and empirical realities. Study metaphysics.
We don't do that.